There is a podcast brewing that's about to take over podcasting for good. The only podcast that you are going to need to tune into day in, day out, is the Member Guest Podcast.
If I can hit it down the middle of the fairway, that's great. But again, with the driver right now, the driver sucks.
John Daly, and you're listening to the Member Guest Podcast. Rip it, rip it.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, listeners of the Member Guest Podcast. We are back again. My name is Johnny Rue, and I'm joined today by Mr. Jordan Hagel.
Hey, what's it? And what's up? What it do?
What it do? And Mr. Tony Hermes.
What's up, fellas?
Today, we've got a little bit of a different episode today. It's somewhat on brand with some of the stuff we've been doing recently. It's going to be a fun one. We're going to do another kind of trivia-oriented game, but we're going to be playing Guess the Golfer. So what I'm going to be doing is reading a little bit about a few different players. We're going to go achievements, their style, some few things about their character and their appearance. And then if we feel it's necessary, I can also mention their country of origin. And we'll give you guys, the audience, a second to try to guess who the golfer might be. And then we'll get Jordan and Tony's takes, and we'll see where we end up.
So is this going to be like a...
I'm going to be so bad.
Is this going to be like a name that tune? Where
totally.
It's like, I go with the most obscure stat, and then whoever is like, I can name that too. I can name that player in one guess or whatever.
We could. And what I was thinking is we could maybe do it where, like, if you get it right, you get a point. It's going to be tricky because I feel like when one person guesses, that might sway the other person's guess. And you guys might know.
Well, that's the debate on when you make a guess,
yeah,
I guess.
That's true.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes. So let's just jump right into it. Do we want to just go through one of them as like a practice run so we get a feel for how it goes?
I think we just go into it.
Just go for it.
Let's just dive
in. What did you do? You did 8 golfers?
I've got a list of 20. So I figured that we could just kind of like pick and choose. We'll see how it's going, and we'll kind of just go from there.
Let's do this. Let's take the easiest one.
Okay.
And start out, and let's do a practice. Yeah. One on the very, very easiest one that you think.
Tiger.
Yeah, like it's probably going to be Tiger.
It's funny because that one was on my list, but it seemed too easy and too evident. So I was just like, you know, that would have been a good practice one.
Well, give us who you think is going to be the easiest one.
Yeah.
And like what's... How you kind of plan on talking through it.
All right, let's do it. All right, audience, tune in. This is a good one. So his achievements include 4 major championships and multiple PGA Tour wins. His play style is powerful driving and fearless approach shots, particularly in major tournaments. His character and appearance includes imposing physique and confident demeanor on the...
Funny because... Kepka.
Brooks Koepka is the answer.
Oh, we're supposed to say it?
No, let's go through all of it, but I had a feeling, like I was saying, you guys are probably going to know most of these right off the top.
Yeah.
But it'll be good. Let's wait, and we'll pause for a little bit, give the audience a chance to think about it. But
I like it.
And then we'll give our answers.
Yeah, you can maybe do like two things and then pause and then another two things. And yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so we'll give
I
like...
I think I knew that one after like the third one. I was like, okay, it's for sure Brooks.
Yeah, so just like, I like find... See if you can find like the most obscure stat. Like one that's like non-descriptive.
Well, what we could do, like Jordan was saying, we'll say like a couple things and I'll wait. And if you guys know or want to guess, then you can guess instead of just keeping going. Okay,
Love
cool.
All right,
we'll move on. This is the actual thing. Let's get into it. Here we go. Golfer number one. Achievements. 2 major championships, numerous PGA Tour victories. Not super telling right away. His play style is exceptional distance off the tee with a smooth and fluid swing, and he has a remarkable short game. His character and appearance, he is relaxed and has a laid-back attitude, which contrasts with his explosive play.
I feel like I know.
I thought I knew, and I don't think I know anymore.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep going because there's a few more.
When should I guess?
Maybe after these next ones.
Write it. Do you have your phone? Write it down on a notepad and then put your phone down.
So his tall and athletic build, along with his signature fairway strut, define his on-course persona. Notable moment, winning the 2020 Masters with a record-setting 20 under par.
Okay, so I was right. Justin Johnson?
Yeah, DJ.
Jay is correct. Yeah. DJ is our golfer.
I thought DJ won more than 2 majors.
Oh my God.
He's only won 2, the Masters and US the US
Open. Yep. Yeah. He would have won another U.S. Open, I believe, but he had like
three putt from like 4 feet.
Mm. Well, and there was also one that he had a kind of a controversial shot out of a waste bunker.
Yeah, that's right. That wasn't, he didn't know it was a bunker, and it was just like, that was wild.
Yeah, that's the one that threw me off. I thought DJ had won more than two majors, and I was like,
a little bit of a controversial Masters, because it was the COVID shortened one that was in the fall. So totally different types of playing conditions.
And there's so many funny things that you could have thrown in there that would have been super like telling that it was him, but I also want it to be somewhat obscure.
Yeah, that's gotta keep BG.
we don't want to describe anything illegal.
Yeah. Not that we would have. All right, let's go to the next one.
He's a beautiful wife. Okay, moving forward. Achievements, golfer number two. Achievements, three major championships, multiple PGA Tour wins. His play style includes exceptional putting, strategic course management, and a competitive edge.
I think I know who it is.
This player's boyish charm and youthful energy has endeared him to fans, and his focused expression and meticulous pre-shot routine reflect his victory at the 2015 Masters, where he tied the 72-hole scoring record and became the second youngest Masters champion.
Do you have it written down?
Well, it's Spieth.
Yeah.
Okay. Jordan Spieth is correct. You guys are killing
him so much. I know so much about him. I knew it like two or three.
I wanted to preface that one with saying Jordan just does not.
I should have wrote it down. I'm sorry. I'll write it down next time. But
I want to write it down. I want to write it down just so we can give the listeners more.
100%. Yeah.
Info. Cause now I'm getting competitive and I want to guess before.
You guys are killing this. You guys haven't missed one yet. I'm impressed. But that was part of my expectation. All right, we're going to move on to the next one. This golfer's achievements include one major championship and also multiple PGA Tour wins. His character and appearance, we're going to go play style first. He has strong iron play and precise ball striking with a calm demeanor under pressure.
I know it too.
Put your phone down. Put your phone down.
Like you guys already know. So character and appearance, stoic expression and focused concentration on the course, which reflect his disciplined approach to golf. His consistent performance and dedication have made him a prominent figure in the sport. Notable moment, becoming the first male Japanese player to win a major championship at the 2021 Masters Tournament. So
you're way wrong.
Oh,
did you too?
Yep.
No kidding.
Did you think it was JT?
No.
Who do you think it was?
Morikawa.
Ooh.
But he has multiple. It's Hideki. Yeah.
Mr. Matsuyama.
It's a Hideki. But that once I was thinking about it, and then Morikawa has two majors.
Yeah.
And only has, you named off only one.
So I'm glad.
That's why I knew I was wrong.
So should we keep going further into depth like that? Okay.
Does JT only has the one major, right?
He has two PGAs.
Oh, he has two.
So it looks like I'll just skip the next guy we're going to do. The next guy is JT.
Well, that's why we have 20 golfers, right?
Yeah, exactly.
We've got a long list to go from.
Love it.
Okay. Our next golfer. Achievements include two major championships and PGA Championship debut win. His play style includes precise iron play, strong ball striking, and a composed mental approach. This gentleman's youthful appearance and composed demeanor have made himself a rising star in golf. His measured approach to the game and calculated decision-making set him apart. Notable moment, capturing his first major title at the 2020 PGA, hitting a clutch drive on the 16th hole to set up a tournament-clinching eagle. This player is...
Colin Morikawa.
Ding, 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 Colin.
Okay, wrote it down.
Tony's killing it.
Kawa.
Hit it on the green with the driver on 16.
So sick.
Kawa.
That's tricky. That's what I was worried about. Like the notable moments are so telling for the really recent ones. Cause it's like, that's to name any of those
but that's
wins.
Good. Once you get to the end, it should be pretty.
It's awesome.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, cool.
But I was way off on JT, man. And you thought it was Kawa.
Well, what's funny? It didn't happen until the very end. Obviously when you said Japanese, then everybody knows who he is.
But. Yep. True. Okay.
So I got that one wrong too, but that's good.
All right, we'll just roll right into the next one. We'll keep firing, rapid fire. Our next golfer, his achievements include multiple PGA Tour wins and consistent major tournament performance. His play style is a versatile game, strong tee to green play, ability to excel under pressure. Character and appearance, this gentleman's calm and collected demeanor on the course contrast with his steely resolve in critical moments. Notable moment would be winning the gold medal at the 2021 Tokyo Olympics, showcasing his ability to perform on the global stage. This golfer is
Ricky Fowler. I was no
it's Xander.
It is Xander.
I thought it was Ricky early on because no major championships, but plays well in majors. Yep.
And when I dropped the Olympics one, I had a feeling Olympics that Ricky was going to throw.
Did
off
you guys too. Know that that's Xander Schauffele's autograph there on that Waste Management 2022 flag?
No I kidding. Did I didn't know that. Know that.
You couldn't guess it if, but now when you look at it, it's kind of sideways. You see the X.
Yeah,
Xander.
How did that come together?
I bought it.
It was an eBay pickup.
I paid money for it.
Yeah. Well, I needed to get a Waste Management Open flag, and for whatever reason, they had one signed by Xander, and it was like really cheap. I was like, absolutely.
That's a baller. Yeah. Oh
my God. I like that.
I love that. Yeah. I love that. Okay. This one should be fairly easily identifiable.
It's going to make me feel bad when I get it wrong.
No, you're going to get this one. You're going to know this one. All right. So his achievements include, and I'm going to tag something onto this too. One major championship and multiple PGA Tour wins. He is one of the golfers who went over to the LIV Golf League. His play style includes.
So I want to guess.
You're going to know real quick.
Just write it down.
Yeah. Write it down and we'll see
don't
if it changes at all.
Don't say anything anymore right now.
Okay.
I wrote it down too.
Your guesses in. Okay. Listeners, you can guess too. His play style includes aggressive distance off the tee, scientific approach to the game, and unconventional equipment choices. Do you want to guess now? Or should I keep going?
I already know.
You can keep going.
Go ahead. We'll keep going for the
Maybe
audience.
Maybe somebody in the audience doesn't know.
So this golfer's bulked up physique and unique cap add to his distinctive appearance, which has changed a little bit, I guess, in very recent time. His analytical approach and dedication to innovation have generated both fascination and debate. Notable moment, capturing his first major title at the 2020 U.S. Open, showcasing a strategic approach and powerful driving on a challenging course. This golfer is.
So that's your 58.
Yep.
Bryson DeChambeau.
Bryson DeChambeau. There you go, fellas.
I saw somebody post on Twitter that Bryson's 58 was the 14th best PGA Tour score of the year. Yeah, or not PGA Tour, professional golf score. So recognized by.
That was nuts.
But it's based on like course rating and a number of factors like that is what I read. So like taking
into
consideration.
They were trying to take it away from him. But, you know,
it ties the best score ever on the PGA Tour. On a PGA Tour sanctioned event is 58 is the best score ever.
Nuts.
But like when you take into consideration all these other factors, that's when it kind of brought it into. Did you guys happen to see that he's playing like a long drive driver?
I saw
that. Yeah, it's like a crank driver or something.
Crank, yeah.
How
crank.
Nuts is that? Like,
I mean, guess, after he threw Cobra and Puma under the bus, man, he's like, I was playing inferior equipment for the last 5 years. It's like, God damn.
So interesting to think that there could be a driver that's made for long drive. Like they said, it was something about increased stability and maybe it can just handle much speed, but just bizarre, right? I mean, you'd think anyone trying to pick up distance would just start playing those, but you got to be moving that thing for it to make
so it shows marketing, how much marketing matters in golf.
It's right about that. I'd never heard about him until I saw him playing it.
Oh, really?
Speaking of cool PGA stats. So when I went to Laurel Valley, one of the guys in our group was he was never a like professional golfer. I don't think he even made it on the, might've been in a Korn Ferry qualifier, but anyways, he was saying, he's been told by the PGA he is the only player in PGA history, so he's in the record books, to have a what they call like a cycle for golf. He had a triple bogey, double bogey, bogey, par, birdie, eagle, double eagle, and an ace, I think, all in one round.
What?
So 9 different scores on 9 holes.
Oh, really? Good.
No, this guy I played with at Laurel Valley.
Dude, that's insane. What?
What did he shoot on that round?
Like 3 over.
That's wild.
Triple, double, bogey, par, birdie, eagle, double. I think it ends at double eagle because I think the ace counts as a double eagle. I can't remember.
Yeah.
Because like you can't count an ace and a double eagle. It's like the same thing.
I mean, even having an ace in
eight different
albatross
scores
in one round. Holy
on
shit.
8 through 18 holes.
Wow.
That's incredible. I wish I could do that.
It's a very obscure stat.
Maybe take the triple.
Isn't that crazy?
Dude, that is crazy. Oh my God.
Sounds like one of my rounds.
It's incredible. Before we get off Bryson too, did you guys watch? I didn't watch it while it was happening, but the recap of that 58 round, some of the putts that he was making and some of the shots he was hitting, it was insane.
And he had a bogey. And did you, I'm sure you guys have seen this, but in LIV, if you shoot 54, you get $54 million bonus. So he would have made $54 million.
Wow.
I mean, he shot 58 with a bogey.
Pretty sick.
That's insane.
You know, 54.
He had a couple whip outs and like makeable putts, and he made a bogey on the one hole. So if that would have flipped to a birdie, now he's at
56.
He just has to make two more putts, and he's.
I wonder if he was thinking about that at all. I mean,
he said he absolutely was.
Oh, really? For sure.
Yeah.
Wow. How could you not?
$54 million.
That's insane.
In one round.
And if you shoot that 54, you're going to have a good chance at winning too, I'm sure. So that kind of compounds quickly.
Speaking of low scores too, I played with Hillen the other day, shot a 63. Yeah, I think I told you that. Oh no, you were with, I was on the back nine,
dude. It was insane.
He's an animal. That dude, yeah.
Four on the front, four on the back, easily could have had three more too.
He was like,
you know, it's kind of soft. I'm like, dude, you just shot a 63.
Yeah, I don't care what you...
You got to get the ball in the hole, man.
If you're playing a par three course and you shoot 63,
it's still a windsong from 6,800. And
isn't that dirty? Yeah. The only time I've seen him play was in the first shootout hole at the member guest when I played with my pops there. And I just remember we were standing on 11 and he was the first up to hit. And I see him line up just like on the most aggressive line. For the listeners, it's a dog leg left hole, pretty short. If you can drive the ball far, you can have a really short shot in. He lines up and just rips a drive to probably 20 yards out, just short of the green. And I'm sitting there like, we got to go next. He was insane. I was like, what did we get ourselves into?
Guy, do you want to hit now? I don't want to hit.
That's what I was like, okay.
Just want to go first in that situation.
It was absurd. So, all right, we'll keep rolling here. Our next player, his achievements include multiple PGA Tour wins and Ryder Cup standout performance. His play style is characterized as stylish and fluid motion. He is a creative shot maker and has a strong short game. This player's vibrant fashion sense and outgoing personality have made him a fan favorite. Notable moment, earning a key victory at the Players' Championship in 2015, solidifying his status as one of the game's rising stars. This golfer is...
Big Dick Rick.
All right.
Ricky Fowler.
Yes, sir.
So I wrote it down after like the first three, but then you said something in the middle that threw me off. What was like the third or fourth thing you said?
Let's see.
Multiple tour wins, shot shaping. So I...
Long short game.
Something honestly, else early on that I was like,
Ryder Cup stand
in my head.
No, that's when I wrote it down.
Oh, okay.
I thought it was
okay.
Ricky.
In my head, I was going down the path of Ian Poulter because you were talking about
the fashion
like,
sense,
you know, Ryder Cup standing or you
true
know, presence, all that.
That would have been a good one for
I
that
was thinking
too.
Ian
you're right.
Poulter, but
I should have just said orange and you guys would have known right away.
Do
you guys ever see the videos of him? I don't remember if it was a Puma ad or what it was, but. Him dirt biking on a golf course. That was pretty insane. I should have
dirt biking on a golf
course. He was like growing up, he was a big like motocross rider.
Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's legend.
Yeah, Ricky's a stud, man. So cool.
All right. So we'll roll on to the next one. This guy's a fan favorite. So this player's achievements include multiple PGA Tour top 10 finishes, Ryder Cup participation, and as of recent, his first PGA Tour win. His play style, and well, not super recent, but don't look into that too much. His play style includes exceptional distance off the tee, strong ball striking, and versatility on the golf course. This man is humble demeanor and impressive athletic, genuine interactions
made
him relatable
right
to audiences. And he is also a fan favorite in the Netflix series.
You know,
this player is Tony Finau.
Yep.
The Tone.
Got that one.
Yeah. We love the Tone.
So good.
Finau
Minnesota
fresh.
Legend, 3M legend. You guys are crushing it. I love it. This one might be a little bit trickier. I'll be curious to see if you guys get this one. Excuse me. All right. Our next golfer, his achievements include multiple European Tour wins, Ryder Cup standout as well. His play style is smooth and rhythmic with strong ball striking and exceptional touch around the greens. This gentleman's distinctive hair and British charm have made him a recognizable figure. His composed demeanor and steady play underline his competitiveness. Notable moment. An electrifying final round at the 2018 U.S. Open where he finished second by a single stroke, showcasing his ability to contend on golf's biggest stages. This golfer is... This one...
Do you know it?
I don't have it on top of my head right now.
Oh, did I stump you guys?
He's British.
It's a European, obviously, with distinctive hair is where I'm going down, and he plays in the Ryder Cup.
You're gonna... Once I tell you, you're going to be like, oh...
Don't say it.
Long hair, you said?
Notable.
No, distinctive. Distinctive notable hair.
Distinctive notable hair. British.
No, you did not say he's not won any majors.
He didn't say that he's won a major.
Multiple European tour wins.
Mm. So maybe he's never won on the PGA though.
It's Tommy Fleetwood.
It's Tommy Fleetwood. There you go. Yep. There you go.
Nice.
See, as soon as you hear it, you're like, oh, of course. Yeah. Of course, Tommy.
Yeah, he has won on the PGA, has he?
Isn't that nuts? Yeah, he's such a beast.
Wow. That was a good one. Really good one, Johnny.
I love it. All right. I think you guys are going to know this next one.
Yep.
All right. Our next golfer's achievements include multiple PGA Tour wins, and he is a FedEx Cup champion. His play style includes precise ball striking, solid putting, and a methodical approach to course management. Character and appearance, quiet and composed presence on the course masks his fierce competitive spirit. His focused gaze and deliberate routines highlight his dedication to the game. Notable moment, capturing the 2021 FedEx Cup title. All right,
Justin Rosia.
Nope.
Patrick Cantlay.
Patrick Cantlay. Patty Ice.
Rose win? Or did he not win?
It's been a while if he has.
I love Cantlay. How about Cantlay the playoff, him versus Bryson?
Wow, that was for the
he's won the BMW the last FedEx. 2 years.
Beast.
He's won the BMW the last 2 years.
I wish he was part of the Netflix series because I would love to like see.
That'd be boring, dude. Like, he wouldn't even talk. He'd freaking be standing over a iron shot for like fucking 5 minutes.
He has got a lot of hate for his pace of play, hasn't he? I love him though. He's just dialed. I don't know.
Okay. Justin Rose did win 2018, so I wasn't too far off.
Yeah, that was a good guess.
Yeah. I thought, okay. All right, I'm not crazy. I was just wrong, but I'm not crazy.
All right, we've got a few left. We're getting towards the end of it, but we'll just kind of keep pumping through them. This one, I think you guys will know. This golfer's achievements include PGA Tour wins, and he is known for his unique swing. Play style, unconventional swing with incredible power, creativity in shot making, and a fearless attitude. Character and appearance, the unorthodox swing and youthful exuberance set him apart. His exuberant celebrations and carefree demeanor add to his distinctive appeal. Notable moment, winning his first PGA Tour event at the 2019 3M Open shortly after turning professional. This golfer is Matt Wolf.
Wow.
Unique swing kind of set it all, didn't it?
Yeah.
My mind was going a lot of different places there, and it didn't, until you said 3M, I actually didn't have it in my head. And then obviously once you said that, it was kind of a shoe-in, but
I didn't think
that was a super easy one.
Really? Okay, no. Good.
It wasn't a super easy one. Just people have kind of gotten by the wayside a little bit since his departure to live. But
true. I wanted to mention too that he worked with George Gankus, who we recently had on the show, which you guys will hopefully see something of very soon. But Matthew Wolf, ladies and gentlemen.
That one.
All right, moving to the next one. Another fan favorite here. This golfer's achievements include PGA Tour wins and low amateur at multiple majors. Play style includes strong ball striking, consistent play, and impressive composure under pressure. Character and appearance, youthful energy and friendly demeanor, which have made him a promising young talent. His clean-cut appearance and respectful interactions reflect his grounded character. Notable moment, earning the low amateur honors at the 2019 Masters, showcasing his potential as a rising star in professional golf. This golfer is.
Do you know it?
No.
I'll give you guys one more hint.
Hold on. I want to see if I can guess this, but before 2019, low AM at the Masters.
Yep.
Can you reread the entire thing? Sorry.
Clean cut.
Yeah. And I want to add one. I might give it away too much.
Don't give away.
Just reread them.
PGA Tour wins are part of his achievements, and low amateur at multiple majors. His play style consists of strong ball striking, consistent play, and impressive composure under pressure. This gentleman's youthful energy and friendly demeanor have made him a promising young talent. His clean-cut appearance and respectful interactions reflect his grounded character. Notable moment, low am at the Masters in 2019. This golfer is.
I feel like there's two or three guesses that I have, but I might embarrass myself if they're not.
Just let them fly.
So the first two that came to my mind were Max Homa, but I feel like he's a little too old, so it can't be him. And older, I don't remember him being like low am or anything. And then the one that I actually think it is, if I had, would be Victor Hovland.
PGA.
That's it. Oh, it is Hovland. Let's go.
Hovland. There you go, Jordan. I initially thought
Homa, and then I was like, man, it sounds and feels like Hovland.
What was your last one?
I didn't know he was low AM multiple times and at the Masters in 2019.
I was going to say he won back-to-back at Mayakoba.
Oh, I don't think that would have given it away. For me, at least. If you would have said, struggled through, chipping yips, then I would have got it for sure.
That was kind of a tough one because I was going to say something about his smile and how he always looks high.
Initially, I thought Will Zalatoris, and then you said something that totally gave it away that it wasn't him. Mm. And my mind went back to Max Homa. I was like, he's too old.
Yeah.
And then Hovland clicked.
Yeah, that was a tricky one.
I like that one.
I knew that one was going to be a little bit obscure.
I like that.
Okay. Next one. We've got three left. Three kind of tricky ones. This golfer's achievements include PGA Tour wins, and he is known for his driving, play style, explosive distance off the tee, athleticism, and a balanced all-around game. This golfer's powerful drives and friendly disposition make him a compelling figure. His engaging interactions and dedication to community initiatives showcase his positive impact. Notable moment, capturing his first PGA Tour win at the 2018 Sanderson's Farms Championship, emphasizing his potential to contend at the highest level. This golfer is
Cameron Champ.
Okay. Cameron Champ it is. Tone.
I didn't know who that was.
Let's go.
Nice.
I wanted to maybe mention the 3M in there too, but we've mentioned the 3M a lot of times in this list. So.
Yeah. Can't be too biased to our Minnesota audience because we do have a global audience.
Yeah. He's a beast though, isn't he?
Good call, Tony. I would have had to think on that a little bit longer.
All right. Rolling on to the next one. This will be tricky. I'll be curious to see if you guys get this one. This golfer's achievements include PGA Tour wins, and he is also known for his consistent play. Play style includes accurate ball striking, solid putting, and a patient approach to course management. This player's steady and focused demeanor on the course reflects his disciplined approach to golf. His dedication to improvement and genuine interactions with fans define his career. Notable moment, earning his first PGA Tour victory at the 2018 Australian Open, marking a significant achievement in his career. This golfer also is invested in tequila. This golfer is.
I have two guesses, but neither of them are for sure. Invested in tequila makes me want to guess Keegan Bradley.
Not Keegan Bradley. It's the I'm blanking on his name right now.
Gosh, what is his name? Invested into Jason Day?
No,
it is not Jason Day.
He's won way before 2018.
Yeah.
Follow him much on Instagram. He has a very unique caddy who's also known for smoking cigarettes on the golf course and has a fascination with hot dogs.
It's not Joel Damon, is it?
It's not Joel Damon.
He's from Colombia or Argentina or something like that.
Argentina?
He's from South America.
His first name and last name start with the same letter.
I bet somebody knows this and is just yelling
right now.
What's it start with? What's the letter?
A.
Abraham answer.
Yeah. Abraham answer. Yeah. Yep. That's the boy.
Abe.
Look up the Dale Trail on Instagram. That's his caddy. He's goofy as hell. He's so funny.
I mean, the only reason I got that is because I just know the name Abraham answer. Nothing else in that gave it away for me.
That was a tricky one. He's like a less compared to some of the other guys we've named.
One is what is, yeah.
Beast. This is our last one.
This is our last one.
All right. Last one. Let's do it.
And I think you guys will know this one pretty easily. This golfer's achievements include PGA Tour wins, major win, and he was and is still somewhat of a rising star. His play style includes versatile game with impressive shot-making abilities, and he is very strong under pressure. His character and appearance include composed and approachable nature and makes him relatable to fans. His youthful energy and competitive spirit are evident in his interaction on and off the course. Notable moment, showcasing his potential by contending at the 2020 PGA Championship and 2020 US Open, and eventually going on to win a Masters. This golfer is.
Oh, I thought I knew it, and then I didn't.
Went on to win the Masters.
contended in multiple majors.
I'm just going through Masters winners right now in my head. So
I'm trying to think of another hint that I can give you guys that won't totally give it away. Well,
it's within the last 4 years of Masters champions then, because he was just talking about how this person contended in these other two majors.
So we've had Tiger, you've had DJ,
Hideki.
You've had Hideki. We've already gone through all three of those.
Yep.
He is a man of faith. Oh, he also Scottie has a
Scheffler.
Unique move.
Scottie Scheffler.
This golfer is Scottie Scheffler.
I don't know how I didn't think of Scottie Scheffler.
You guys did a good job. You kind of crushed that. I'm impressed. Well, it's there was only two out of 20 that you guys didn't really
know. What the cool thing about that is like it really showcases how much like you have a perception of a golfer, right? Or an opinion about them. And then you just hear like that one, Scottie Scheffler, you would think would be one of the easiest ones to get. Right? And all of a sudden it's like, either a brain fart or just, I didn't really think of it in that light, or I thought was better or worse, whatever.
Was there anything about like a unique swing or unique footwork in the wording there?
Yeah, but I didn't want to say anything about that because I figured it would give it away too easily.
Gives it away.
Like footwork. And then also like him being one of the best golfers in the world in the last year or two. There was some of the stuff I was trying to make it a little bit more tricky.
That's a good thing, because then you uncover things about some of these golfers that you never would have, you can always give dead giveaways. What you can't do is... do things that people don't understand. So
it's just kind of it's a fun exercise just because there's so many unique different personalities. And I found myself like thinking of players in my head. And then like almost eliminating those players based on the stats versus like highlighting or identifying them based on the stats that you gave.
That's a good way to do it. You're right.
But yeah, I thought it was fun.
Yeah, no, it is fun. We've had a lot of feedback from listeners lately loving like the stats or the interactive. Like, dude, I got ripped for saying we should do games on the podcast. And now we are just absolutely loving the games.
It's a good time. Change things up a little bit. And I hope everyone listening at home or watching at home had a little bit of fun guessing along with us. So
yeah, that was awesome. Thanks, Johnny.
Yeah.
I will say next time we do it, we should do a little bit older. Some older guys too, because some of these ones are, I mean, a lot of these are current day, which is great,
have an older audience too.
We do have some older audience. You know,
I have old friends now.
I would love to be guessing like Freddie Couples or, you know.
I'd be atrocious at it, but I'd love to do it. I'd embarrass myself, but I'd love to do it.
It was fun. The first list that I did, it was like Bobby Jones, Greg Norman, Lee Trevino, who else was on there? Annika Sorensen or Annika, however you say it. There was just a long list of ones. And I'm like, let's keep it fresh. And then maybe, if we want to revisit this, I'll make another list and we'll do it. But
one day we'll do a member guest podcast Jeopardy.
Yeah.
Like I'll be the host and you three can like be up in your stands and we'll, do like golf history, golf courses. Yeah. That'd be so sweet. Somebody's going to steal that. All right. Till next time.
Till next time.
Appreciate you, Johnny.
Yep. Thanks for tuning in and thanks for playing. Hope you guys enjoyed.
All right, Ballas.
Take care.
Yeah. Hell yeah.